In this video, I want to talk a little bit about the Canadian dollar. Now, the Canadian dollar has been pretty good for us lately. We've been bringing it up to the top of our list of watch markets. And as you can see, we've had quite a bit of activity here recently over the last month or so. And this market's been quite wild. Yesterday, we had a really good day where the market moved quite a bit. So usually, we'll look for another day following a big day like that. And today is another day that we've been having some activity going on here in the Canadian dollar. So pretty excited about that. If we drop down to the range bar 6 chart, you can see that first thing here in the morning, we had a nice little indication of a break coming in here. Now, this first trend line came in here right around the before the opening of our market. This is the New York time frame, this white line right here. But if we just kind of draw a little trend line, you see we had kind of this little half shelf sitting there. And the market dropped below that. That's kind of a nice little formation that we look for, kind of a little sideways channel, looking for an entry opportunity. If we miss that, well, then, you know, we have to draw these trend lines in here. And as you can see, the market came in, and we had another trend line break right in here. Now, you have to remind yourself that these blue lights are like mathematically calculated trend lines. And so it's the crossing of these trend lines that gives us the overall trend of the market. So when we get a crossover of the trend line and it corresponds with the blue lights and the trend line that we're drawing, of course, we want to make sure that we can draw a trend line at that same location. And then we can narrow from the bulls and bears. That's a nice confirmation that we can get into this market for a position. And here again, we have another nice trend line that came right down here, breaking right at about the same time as that blue light of the bulls and bears blue light system. And that market started to rally once again. Of course, using the blue light as a trailing stop is how we exit the market. So if we wanted to simply just draw a calculator from our entry point to our exit, that was a small move of about $80 this morning. If we come in here and just go off this little break right here that we talked about, that was about a $140 move. And if we come in here off of this this entry point right here, this breaking of the trend line, let's go off the blue light to the current trading position, that's about a $215 move. Now, realize that those numbers don't represent commissions and fees, but we also want to be very conscious of the turning points of the stochastics indicator and the momentum indicator. We want to be very aware that we want to be looking at these points and making sure that these markets are in the oversold region down in here before we take a long position. And we want to make sure that they're up here in the overbought region before we take a short position. So we want those things to all kind of line up together, draw the trend lines, and don't overtrade. You know, if this doesn't look good to you at the time, it's a little bit easier in hindsight, obviously, to see these positions. But getting used to this, watching this in real time is a little bit more difficult. But when we get into the market, make sure that we protect ourselves. Don't take a big loss. If that market doesn't decisively move in our favor and starts to go against us, just get out. It's not a market you want to be in anyway. What we want to do is we want to make sure that when we're a short position, there's no buying pressure. And when we're in a buying position, there's no selling pressure, and that the market continues to rally in the direction that we got in immediately upon entry. If not, just get out. There's another opportunity, and the biggest thing we want to do is protect our initial investment. We don't want to lose our little nest egg of just on trying to get into the market. So make sure the market moves decisively in your favor. If not, just get right back out. All right, and that's just a quick wrap-up of this morning's Canadian dollar.